Dr. Willis. We have Willis here that's going to come, and he's going to give the word of the Lord. Let's give a warm, warm welcome to Willis Otanga. Amen. As he's going to share with us what the Holy Spirit has placed upon your heart. We sure love you guys.
Father, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we welcome you here today. I thank you that God, where two or three are gathered, you're there. Father, I pray that you speak to us today. We humble ourselves before you today, God. Speak to us today, Father. We thank you for your anointing tonight, today, God. We thank you that your word goes forth and produces fruit in our hearts, God. In Jesus' name, amen. I just want to take a moment to say thank you to Pastor Ken and Pastor Shah and Pastor Catalina and Pastor Mike is not here. You guys are just awesome. Thank you for all the years that you have labored. And thank you for many, many, many sleepless nights you've spent on your knees for us. And the message this morning is about you guys. I'm just kidding. So... maybe just a little bit. So we just watched a young girl, don't know how old she was, 12 years old. We watched her step out of her comfort zone and talk about something we don't even feel comfortable talking about. We watched her unashamedly, not holding back anything, stand before Parliament and say abortion is wrong, and say every child has a right to live. We watched her say that God has a purpose for every child. And only God gives life. And nobody else but God decides when any child goes home. We watched her plead with the nation to think about the choices that we make, how they affect us, how they affect our nation, how they affect the world, and the message that we send every day when we take a life. God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. When young ones that are 12 years old stand up and be counted, and they are not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ, God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. And that's my message today. God is doing a new thing. Forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I'm doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do you not perceive it? I'm making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. The wild animals honor me, the jackals and the owls, because I provide water in the wilderness and streams in wasteland to give drink to my people, my chosen, you, the people I formed for myself, that they may proclaim my praise. Thirty-some years ago, there was a young man that came to this church, Pastor Ken, and he was 21 years old. correct? Yes. And he took over this congregation, this church, when he was 21 years old. I think he had just come from college. He didn't have much experience working with the religious people. And they're not so religious. But he came and he said, God, if you've sent me here, then I'm going to trust you. So he took over this congregation, and for the last 30-some years, he's been our pastor here. God was doing a new thing back then, and God is doing a new thing today. Pastor Mike and Pastor Catalina, they came to this church many years ago. Maybe some of you think they were hired as pastors when they came in. They went to college and finished their college degree, and then they walked in here and they had an interview, and then they came here for a preaching session so you guys can judge whether or not they're anointed, and then you can decide whether or not you can hire them. No, they came here years ago and they served in the nursery and they cleaned every toilet in this place. And if you came here at midnight on weekdays, they were here vacuuming these floors. They served in this church. And as they served in this church, God began to raise them up. And they've occupied every position in this church because God was doing a new thing and God is doing a new thing. See, that is not how you hire a pastor. You bring them in and you interview them and then you pray. Then you invite them back to come and preach to the congregation, and then you make your decision. But God was doing a new thing. They started here. They were serving. They were submitted. Nothing. They came with a humble attitude. And the attitude they had was simply this: God, we are going to serve you regardless of what we have to do. We are here for you and not for me. And everything that we do is about you and not about me. It's never been about you. It's never been about me. It's always has been and always must be about God. And God, he was doing a new thing. And today they are here, and we've seen what God has been doing because they started with humility and they were submitted to their senior leader, and they never wavered from where what God was doing in their life. They knew that God, if I humble myself before you and I submit to your purposes and I submit to your will, that God, you will lift me up. You will elevate me. God was doing a new thing. And God is still doing a new thing today. Amen? I am African. If you want me to talk to you, you have to talk to me today. Amen? This is not about me. This is about the King of Kings. And today we're going to have dialogue together regarding a new thing that God is doing in our lives. And today we're going to shout and we're going to give him glory because we are alive today. But for God. If it wasn't for God, you'd be here today. If it wasn't for God, you'd be here today. If it wasn't for God, your car would not have started this morning. Some of you are here today because an ordained moment, a God moment, a supernatural moment that God has you in the house today because he has something for you today that will change you forever and forever and forever and forever. You will never be the same when you encounter the King of Kings. When you have an encounter with God, you are forever more changed. You are never the same. And God, he is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Our God is mighty. Our God is awesome. He is great. He is indescribable. He is bigger than you can imagine. He is bigger than your problem. He is bigger than any issue or the situation you find yourself in today. Our God is bigger. And the scripture verse we read this morning tells me that our God, He is limitless. You cannot put Him in a box. You cannot add Him or subtract Him. He is simply God. All the time, has always been God, will always be God. Everything He does for a purpose. And all of His creation, He spoke into existence. God spoke, and there was. Because he is God. He can do today what He has never done before. Hey, in your life, what He has never done before. Where are you today? What are you going through today? What is your situation? God can do today in your life what He's never done before, what has never been done before. You can read every newspaper. You will never find that. God can do a new thing today. Do you believe that? In your heart, do you really believe that? Think about creation. Think about creation, the moon, the stars, the galaxies. He created billions of massive celestial bodies, and he spread them so far that some of them we can't even see with our naked eyes. Only God can see them. Everything God made, He made for the very first time. Everything God made, He made for the very first time. He made every fish in the ocean, every beast of the field, from a gazelle to an elephant. God made every flower, every plant He made, every sea, every ocean, every lake, God made. Every mountain that you can look at, God made. Every drop of snow, God made. And everything that God made, He made it for the very first time. It had never been done before, but God. And that is the kind of God that we serve. That is the kind of God that we serve. Our God is 100% true, and the promises of God are 100% true. Our God is 100% God, and His promises will always be 100% true. You have to believe the word of God. You have to believe the word of God. The word of God can take you out of your situation. The word of God can give you new life today. The word of God can open doors that no demon in hell has the keys to unlock and close them in the name of Jesus. That is the kind of God that we serve. The same yesterday, the same today and forever. I am God, I change not. Yesterday, today, and forever, heaven and earth will pass away, but the word of God that is spoken to eternity in your spirit will never pass away. He is doing a new thing. He is doing a new thing. He, God, is doing a new thing. Remember not the former things, and don't consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness, and rivers in the desert. Hallelujah. Somebody give God praise. If you believe that God's word is true and that God gave His word to change your life and change your situation, give Him praise this morning. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. Talk to God. He wants to hear your voice. Talk to God this morning. Come on, talk to God. Hallelujah. 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 So this is God's prophet, Isaiah, and he's ministering to a people demoralized in exile in Babylon. They had suffered much. The towns and their farms were destroyed. The lands that once belonged to was promised to Isaac. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob was now in the hands of others. And it seemed as if God had abandoned them. But then the words of the prophet came out and God spoke to them, like he's speaking to us this morning. And he says, don't remember the former things or consider the things of old. I'm about to do a new thing. 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 God's word brings hope to your situation. I'm doing a new thing. God's word brings life to your situation. I'm doing a new thing. God's word brings life to your mountain. I'm doing a new thing. God's word brings life to your sickness. I'm doing a new thing. God's word brings life into your financial situation. I'm doing a new thing. God's word brings life into your job that you've been at for years and years and you don't like anymore. There is no other place to go. You've just been there. You are plateaued there and you've been there for a long time. God's word brings life into that situation today because he, God, I am doing a new thing, says the Lord. I am doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. Have you ever felt like just giving up and throwing a towel? I've worked with many kids over my years. I'm old. And I've talked to many young adults. And I've sat down with them. And this past week, I sat down with this young man. And he looked at me and he told me, what's the point in being alive? I'm going to end it all. I have a plan. And then he went on and read his plan to me. And then he looked at me in the eye and he said, and there's nothing you can do about it. Because when you came here, you said everything we talk about will be confidential. And I looked him in the eye and I said, I also did say, when it puts you at risk and anybody else, I don't care what the law says. God is doing a new thing, even in hopeless situations, that God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. If you've ever been at a place where you felt that everything that you've worked so hard for and everything you've worked so hard to hang on to, everything that you want, everything that has given you purpose and everything that makes you happy, all that is slipping away from you and you have no control over it. I want you to know that he is still God and he is doing a new thing. 1 year ago, in this church, we gathered in that parking lot with one of your pastors, 31 of us. We got in the vans and we started a journey to a place called Manteca, California. We had no idea what was going to happen, but all we knew was that God was going to meet us. We didn't know what that was going to look like, but all we knew is that God had called us to make that trip, and we trusted him. We knew that our pastors and the leaders of this church heard from God, and we submitted to that process, and we said, God, we will just go where you lead us. We don't know what the outcome is going to be. And for some of us, it was a difficult trip because I grew up in Africa and I grew up camping every day. When you tell me to sleep on the floor, I have issues. Because I slept on the floor for my whole life. But on this trip, I looked at our pastor Mike and I told him, if it is God, I will sleep on the floor. It is okay. If it's God, I'll drive for 20 hours straight. It is okay. I will do it because God was doing a new thing. And I know some of you are here today because God was doing a new thing then and God was doing a new thing today. And the reason why some of you are here today is because your pastor was willing to submit to the voice of God. He was willing to submit to the purpose of God. He was willing to submit to the leadership, to his senior leader. And he said, we heard from God and we must take this journey. Because in taking this journey, that God will meet us. Because in taking this journey, we will never be the same. Because in taking this journey, our awakening will start in our city. In taking this journey, our homes will be changed forever. And today you are here because one man heard the voice of God and submitted to the call of God. Obedience is better than sacrifice. He was doing a new thing. He is still doing a new thing today. Where you are today, you can't stay there because God is doing a new thing. God is desiring this morning to bring all of us into a place of stability where his kingdom flows through us and changes atmosphere. God is wanting this morning to bring us to a place of stability where his kingdom is flowing through us and is changing our neighborhoods, and our friends are changing, and our schools are in chaos just because we wake up in the morning and we show up because we carry the presence of God with us. God, he is doing a new thing. He is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. We love affirmations and we love to quote scriptures like this. I am more than a conqueror through Jesus who gives me strength. For you to be a conqueror, I got some news for you this morning. You have to conquer something. Quit quoting the word of God unless you're willing to walk it out. You have no authority except to take the word of God and to walk it out. That's the only way you conquer. When you wake up in the morning and you declare, I am more than a conqueror, every devil in hell should tremble because you're up and you're filled with the presence of God. And there's nothing that's going to deter you and take you off course because your eyes are stayed on him. Your eyes are stayed on him. Your mind is stayed on him. God is doing a new thing. Yes, you are more than a conqueror, but wake up every morning and be prepared to take your school for Jesus. Wake up every morning and be prepared to take your city for Jesus. Wake up every morning and conquer something. Conquer something. Eat up the word of God and walk it out every day. Walk it out, walk it out, walk it out. Hallelujah. 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 The Bible says, therefore, put on the full armor of God so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything, stand. can't stand when you've done nothing. The Bible says, after you have done everything, after you have labored before the throne of God, after you have contended for your family member, for your loved ones, after you've stood in the gap for your city, for your nations, then you stand. After you've done everything, stand. So many of us stand and do nothing. That is not what the word of God said. After you've done everything, where's the man and the woman of God who is willing to do everything? You're willing to do what it takes to see this city change, to see this nation change. You are willing to stand like this little girl that we saw here today and say, God, I don't care what the world thinks about me. I have my convictions, and my convictions are rooted in the word of God. And I am not ashamed to stand up and be counted. And I am not ashamed to do everything. And after I've done everything, I'll stand and see the faithfulness of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What are you standing on today? What are you standing on today? What are you standing on today? Are you standing on the word of God today? Are you standing on the word of God today? Are you standing on the lies of the devil? Or are you still sleeping in your bed and saying, after you've done all, to stand? You're out of line. If that's where you are, you need to wake up. You need to get out of your bed and you need to begin to contend today, because God is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. 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 We need to understand that our God is far more interested in our future than he is in your past. That your God is far more interested in your future than he is in your past, because you'll spend eternity in your future, not in your past, because the choices you've made in the past don't determine where you go today. They don't determine what you do today. You need to trust God. Your eternity is spent in the future, and God is concerned about all of us. God is concerned about all of us. Jesus, his only son, he hung on a tree and they beat him and he was despised because God was looking to the future for the joy that was set before him. He endured. He endured. It wasn't easy. He endured the cross for the joy, because God is a God of the future. He was concerned about you. He had you in his mind. He was doing a new thing. He is doing a new thing. And the Bible says, remember not those things. Whatever has held you down in the past, God wants to redeem. He wants to lift you up out of that situation. And he wants to put you in the now, because he is doing a new thing today. Amen. 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 Remember not. Remember not. If you're holding on to something that you never had, that was never yours to begin with, you've got to give it up today. If you're holding on to past hurts and pains, you have to give it out today. God is doing a new thing. If you're holding on to unforgiveness and you're sitting here this morning, it is time to lay it down. But for the very last time, I am doing a new thing today. If you are holding on to your talents that God told you, you need to lay them at the cross, at the feet of Jesus. Give it all today. I am new. I'm doing a new thing. If there's a situation that you're used to handling by yourself, and God today is speaking and say, I want your hands off of it. Take your hands off. God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. Let the past be the past. Forget the former things. God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. Forgetting those things that are behind us, I stretch. He is doing a new thing. He is doing a new thing. It don't matter what your mama did. It doesn't matter what your father did. It doesn't matter what the world has done to you. It does not matter. God, he is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. 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 There's a release that God is wanting to release into your spirit, into my spirit, that will only come when we forget and lay it all down and don't dwell on the past and don't have any hang-ups about who did what and who said what and all that stuff. God is doing a new thing. Every word that comes out of your mouth, you'll give an account. Every idle word that you speak to your friends about the leaders of this church, you will God will hold you accountable. Everything that you say about your elders, God will hold you accountable. And your deacons, God will hold you accountable. Every idle word that you speak against your brother and your sister, you will give an account. You will not get away with it, because today God is doing a new thing. He is doing a new thing. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall ye not know? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God makes everything new because he's a redeeming God. God takes that which everybody thought could never amount to anything, and he takes it up and he does something with it because he's a redeeming God. Because what the devil had meant for evil and everything that the devil had wanted to use to destroy you and destruct your life, God turned it around. He is a redeeming God. He is a redeeming God. He will take all your messes and create a message that will change your culture and change this nation and our city forever. I've been messed up many times. I've made a lot of mistakes in my life. But God has always been faithful. If you get up and you keep walking and you keep trusting and you keep believing, God will turn it around. God will turn it around. You don't get to conquer without conquering. Hallelujah. 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 Sometimes when God is doing a new thing, he uses ways that don't make any sense to us. Like speaking to Pastor Mike and Catalina and having them clean the washrooms every day and pick up garbage around the church every day and telling them that I'm raising you up, that you're going to be leaders in this church. That made no sense. But God was doing a new thing. God commanded Noah. He said, Noah, build me an ark. Because of the wickedness that God found in the land. And the Bible says Noah was a righteous man and he walked by faith. And God gave him a mandate. And his instructions to Noah were so clear in terms of what wood to use and how to stitch it all together and how to put it all together. God gave very specific instructions. There's never been a bot up to that point that had ever been built quite that large or looked like that. It was a new thing. There's never been rain, and yet there was going to rain, and there was going to be a flood. Noah had to step up by faith and say, God, I believe your word. It makes no sense. In the mockery, and when people looked at him and laughed at him, he worked tirelessly because he believed the word of God. God was doing a new thing. God, he was doing a new thing. When Moses installed Joshua as a leader, the first order Joshua gave Israel was to march around the city. There's never been a battle before where simply you showed up into the battlefield and you marched around the city and you defeated your city, your enemy. Joshua sent 12 spies into the land that God promised them. 10 came back and said they were spies. 2 came back and said, yeah, we agree with them, but God is on our side. The first need they needed to take was Jericho. And they say that if you read your Bible, if you study Bible, they say that the walls in Jericho were so thick they used to race chariots on top of the walls. They were that thick. And those very specific instructions that you will march around the city 7 times. God was doing a new thing. There were no guns involved. There weren't big army trucks ready to go into Iran and ready to go into Iraq and bring the city down. No, he simply gave his orders and he said, you will continue, you will march around the city 7 times. And so they went and they marched around the city. God was doing a new thing. It had never been done before. There's no other place in history where the army or the people of God, where anybody has defeated anybody without a gun. God was doing a new thing, and they marched, and the Israelites, they marched, and they marched around the city, and they marched the 5th time, and the 6th time, they are getting tired, and they continue to march. On the 7th day, they marched around the city, and they shouted in faith, and they shouted in victory, and every wall that stood in front of them came crumbling down. God was doing a new thing. I don't care what you're going through today, what situations you are stuck in today. Where you're at today is not your ending. Where you are today is not your ending. Some of you, you've been carrying a promise in your spirit. You've been pregnant with a promise of God. You've been pregnant with a new job. You've been pregnant with business ideas. Don't give up. Keep on marching. Keep on marching. Keep on marching. Keep on standing. Keep on trusting. Because after you've done all, you need to be able to stand. And when you stand, watch God do what he promised he'll do. There is no wall that will be left standing if you submit to the word of God and to his voice. If you submit to his voice, if you'll be willing to step out of your comfort zone. I'm telling you tonight, today, that this in this room here, there are multi-billionaires that God is raising up for the kingdom of God, not for your own pleasure, for his kingdom. I am telling you today, if you can believe it, if you can stand on it, if you can declare it, you can have it in the name of Jesus. The devil is a liar. 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 You are not who you were yesterday. You are different because he's done something different in your city. We are not who we were last year. We are different. And if you don't believe me, turn around and look around here. Hallelujah. 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 God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. A shepherd boy is minding his own business. He's tending sheep. He's not concerned about anything else. He's doing what he believes is called to do. And he's doing it so well. And all of a sudden, he's presented with a Goliath. God was doing a new thing. That this shepherd boy who had never fought a Goliath before stands up before Goliath and begins to prophesy and say, who is this Philistine who dares to defy the word of the living God? Who is the Philistine? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? Who is this Philistine who dares to defy the armies of the living God? Sometimes you need to get up your bed. You need to put on the full armor of God. You need to stare that thing into the face. And you need to begin to declare, who are you to defy a man of God? Who are you to defy a daughter of God? Who are you? Who are you? Who are you? And David began to declare, and he said, God, I have killed a bear with my own hands, and I killed a lion with my own hands. I am not afraid. If you be for me, nobody can be against me. And your strength this morning is to look back and see his faithfulness, how he moved in your life, how you could be dead, but God. You're strung out on drugs, but God. Nothing was going right in your life, but God, he showed up, he intervened, he picked you up, and he put you here. I am doing a new thing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I need one more minute, then I'll be finished. God is doing a new thing. Sepo, God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. When you have Nicholas Bullet, and you have Raphael, and you have Dutlov, and you have Pastor Ken, and when you've got Pastor Mike, and you've got Brother Calvin, and they can all come together and sit around the table and talk about the word of God. Nobody feeling left out. Nobody feeling too young. Nobody feeling too immature. God. Come on. Yes. Faith isn't activated by looking back. Your faith is released by partnering with God and participating in what God is doing now. He is doing a new thing. Your faith is released by participating and agreeing with heaven regarding what God is doing in our generation, in your generation, today. He is doing a new thing. There's a switch in the spirit. It's a new season. We are in a season where things that used to take years and years and years, that God is going to accelerate. God is going to accelerate his promise to you, his blessing to you, his word to you. God will accelerate the prophetic words that have been spoken into your spirit in eternity. The word that God spoke to you in eternity, God will accelerate. It's a new day. It's a new hour. It's a new season. You need to stand on the word of God, and you need to believe that God is able. He'll provide water in the wilderness. He will give you water in the wilderness. What is your wilderness today? There is water from the fountain that never runs dry. What situation do you find yourself in today? What makes you wake up in the morning and go, oh, just another day. I'm just living. I'm just barely making it. I can't even pay my bills. But God was always doing a new thing. God, He never left you. He never forsake you. He said, every need that you need, I will provide according to my riches in glory. What is standing in your way? God is doing a new thing. God is doing a new thing. God, hallelujah, God, hallelujah, God, hallelujah, yes, yes, God, God is doing a new thing. He is doing a new thing. He is doing a new thing. There is provision in the kingdom. We've talked about redemption, but there is provision in the kingdom that where God leads, and when He calls you, He has never lied, never sinned. The righteous forsaken, never ever sinned. The righteous forsaken, that He is God and He is true to His word. He is doing a new thing today. In your wilderness, there will be water to drink. Your dead-end job that you think is dead, it's never been dead because God has always been doing a new thing. He's just been waiting on you to submit to the process, His process, and see Him deliver you and give you a promotion. Because when God gets ready to move, you've got to press into it. You have to do some stuff, people. You have to persevere. You have to work hard. You have to be diligent. You've got to stay on your knees. But after you've done everything, to stand and see the salvation of God in your situation. Your business ideas that God gave you, one for nothing. God is going to resurrect every idea that He has given you because He is God. It is time. It is now. God is doing a new thing today in the house. Remember not. And I know we're on a journey. And I know all of us were in different stages in the journey. But I want you to know this morning that no matter where you find yourself in your journey with God, God is still doing a new thing. He is still doing a new thing. He is still doing a new thing in the wilderness, and in, He'll make a way. He's able to move your biggest mountain out of the way. He is able to do a new thing. He is able to do abundantly and above. Abundantly. Above. Oh. God is able. God is able. If He can cause a virgin to conceive a child, He can bring household salvation to your home. God, He is able. He is able. If He can open up the Red Seas and cause His children to walk on dry ground, God can open up every window, every door that the devil has locked in your face, every place you've gone and you've been told no. God is getting ready to open up for you, and you better be ready to walk in it, because He is doing a new thing. It may not look the way you want it to look. It may look different, but you need to trust that He's doing a new thing. Just like your church looks a little different today than it did a year ago. Deep down my heart, I know that God, right here, right now, in this church, He's doing a new thing. And maybe it doesn't look or feel the way I want it to feel, the way you want it to feel. That is really irrelevant, because He, God, He says, I'm doing If God can go and find a dead man, Lazarus, and say, Lazarus, come forth. Lazarus, come forth. The resurrection power of Jesus Christ. Lazarus, come forth. There is power in the name of Jesus. Lazarus, come forth. You need to get up today. Every day you get up, you need to call that situation that is not as though it is. Lazarus, come forth in the name of Jesus. Lazarus, come forth. Every dream that and every broken promise, Lazarus, come forth. Come forth. Every job that I've been looking for, Lazarus, come forth. The situation I find myself in today, Lazarus. Hallelujah. 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 God is able. God is able. And he's about ready to invade your lives, and you will never be the same. He will take you on a ride like no other, because he's always doing a new thing, not like he did yesterday. It is a new thing. You've got to hang on tight and trust on the unchanging word of the living God. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Oh, glory. Well, you know, if we haven't guessed it now, God is doing a new thing. Hallelujah. Let that be the word of the Lord for our hearts. Praise the Lord. Behold, he says, I am doing a new thing. Let's stand, and we are going to invite you to come for prayer. And if you have never given your heart to Jesus Christ, the greatest gift that each and every one of us received is the gift of his Son, the Lord Jesus. Perhaps you walked with God at one time, but you've fallen away, and you're referring to as a prodigal. We call it a prodigal. You want to come home today. You know what? Don't leave this place today without making that decision to say that I want to come back home. And so we want to pray with you as well. Those that are up in the balcony, whoever it is that the Holy Spirit is speaking to you, please don't leave without getting prayer. So let's pray. Father, we just want to thank you for the faithfulness of God. And Lord Jesus, we declare the word of the Lord over our households, over our families, over our cities, that God is doing a new thing in each and every one of our lives. And Father, even as we go out those doors, Lord God, you're sending us out as missionaries. And so, Father, whether it's our next door neighbor, whether it's going to be in the restaurant that we're going to go to this afternoon, wherever it is, Lord God, thank you for just giving us boldness to speak the words of life to those that have no hope. We thank you for that in Jesus' name. And everybody said, hallelujah. Amen. Amen. You're dismissed. God bless you. Those that want.